Now the pastor was devastated. They prayed together, but he went to her house the next day. And he said, she was shocked to see him in a little village, humble home. And he said, we're glad you're coming. We just want to be your church and your pastor. But he said, there's some people upset. She was about, and he said, because you keep getting up and saying you're healed. And he said, as your pastor, if you come back, I forbid you to speak in church publicly as you have the last several weeks. Now, sometimes that may be an order. In this case, it wasn't. He said, you're just, but yet God's plan was in this. He said, this breaks my heart, and I don't want to be here, but there's the confusion and people. And she said, if only all of us had this. She said, how can I go to church and withhold my praise from God? Wouldn't you love for everyone to have that spirit? How can I go to church and hold back my praise to God? He said, well, I want you to come, but until I give you permission, I forbid you to speak. He prayed. He left. And she told Brother Daniel later when he walked out, first thing she said to God was, I will never set foot ever again back in that church. And as soon as she said that, God said to her, yes, you will. Matter of fact, you're going next Sunday. He said, obey your leadership.
Right.
And trust me.
That's right.
Trust me. During that week, she said, like a tennis match, going back and forth, I'm going to go, I'm not going to go, I'm going to go, I'm not going to go. Sunday morning came. She said she woke up. Her first thought was with tears, I cannot go. They're talking about me. I'm embarrassed. And how can I go when people will not let me give God praise? And the Lord whispered to her again and said, you get up like every other Sunday. You get washed, you get dressed. And you trust me. You trust me. She told Mother Daniel, she got up, put on her sari, whatever. They were in India, walked over to the wooden barrel. She filled every Saturday night for water with a mirror, began to wash herself for church. And she said, she put her hand in the bucket. Now, you're going to get ahead of me, but let me enjoy the story. She put her hand in the bucket, splashed on her face, gently on the right side of her face, the tumor. And the excess water, of course, dropped in the bucket, but there was some additional splashes in the bucket that morning. She didn't know what was happening. The second handful of water, the third handful, the fourth handful. With every handful of water, that tumor began to dissolve and literally fall off the side of that woman's face. You say, Greg, impossible. With man, yes. With God, nothing's impossible. At the end of several handfuls, her face was as smooth that you, not a scar you could have never ever told she ever had cancer on the side of her face. So Brother Daniel, she told, what did you do? And she said, I went to church. She said to Brother Daniel, when she walked in that morning, people were taking on second looks and looking and just, they're worshiping, but looking over, is that the woman, is that a twin, whatever. And she never said a word. She worshiped in her heart. She knew God knew her praises and was overwhelmed, but knew she had to obey and be faithful. They sang the song. There came testimonies. She sat there, never said one word. The pastor ended testimonies, began to read his text, but the Spirit of God convicted him and said, called her out, because he kept wondering, is it her, is it somebody else? He stopped and said, he said, ma'am, would you please stand up, point right at her. She stood up, and he said, I know what we talked about. I allow you to speak. He said, are you the woman that had the tumor? She smiled and said, yes. And he said, what happened to you? And like every other Sunday, her right hand shot up in the air. And she said, and I quote, I want to thank the Lord Jesus Christ for healing my body of every trace of cancer. Now the church came unglued with praise and tears and shouts. But the pastor wasn't done. He said, wait a minute. I was at your house 3 or 4 days ago. I saw the tumor. I smelled the tumor. I saw it. He said, when did Jesus heal you? She didn't miss a beat. She shut up her right hand and just said, and I quote, he healed me 2,000 years ago on an old rugged cross. And again, the church would praise him. I wonder who it is in this room tonight. And God's saying, you make room for me, I'll touch you, I'll heal you, I'll set you free. I'll give you more than what you could ever bargain for. Let's stand all over the room. I preached too long, all right? Let's stand. Sing that words of maybe once through, maybe. Let's stand together. Come on. Would you lift a hand up to the Lord right where you are? You've been so faithful, so attentive tonight. Would you just reach your hand up to God right where you are right now?
He's the Prince of Peace.
Lift a hand up and begin to build the room. Build the room right now. Just build the room right where you are right now. He loves you tonight, New Jersey. He loves you tonight, New Jersey. Jehovah, come on, somebody. Let's build God a room of worship right now. Let's worship the Lord all over this room. We worship you tonight, Lord. Come on, sing it to me now. Would you give him your best voice? Somebody sing it to the Lord right now. Surrender. Let's sing it together. Here we go. Come on now. Jesus Christ is Lord. He's your healer. He's your healer tonight. He's your provider. He's everything you're ever going to need. Nothing too hard for God here tonight. We worship you tonight, Lord. We worship you on a Monday night, God, in New Jersey. Worship him out loud right now. Come on. Don't let the cat get your tongue. Come on, somebody. Somebody build God a room of praise right now. Say, Greg, well, I'm not much. I'm lifting my voice. Well, not tonight. Let it be a new room. Would you begin to speak out your praise right now? The Bible says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. The Bible says, if we don't praise him, the rocks will cry out. Oh, somebody worship the Lord right now. Give him praise. Give him glory. McGregor, I don't normally do this. Well, don't do what you normally do. Do a new thing tonight for God's glory. Give him praise and honor. Let faith rise in this house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. We worship you tonight, Lamb of God. Would you just say the name of Jesus? There's power in the name of Jesus. Jesus heals. Jesus delivers. Jesus Christ is a miracle worker.